Good morning everyone, this is Karan Singh and today in this video we will see a topic of English grammar, that is past perfect continuous tense. So let us see where past perfect continuous tense is used. So it is used to denote an action that had been going on at or before some point of a time in the past. So where past perfect continuous tense is used, it is used to denote an action which had been going on at some point of time or before some point of time in the past. Let us see some examples. See the first example, Ram had been watching TV for 2 hours. So here this verb, watching by Ram, had been continue before or at this point of a time in the past. See the second example, it had been raining since morning. So here this verb raining had been continue just before or at this point of a time in the past. See the next example, Nisha had been waiting for me since 11 o'clock in the morning. So here waiting verb by Nisha had been continue in the past. So that is why in these all sentences past perfect continuous tense has been used. I hope where past perfect continuous tense will be used, it will be cleared to you all. If it is clear, let us move to the next point. So here we will see some rules for past perfect continuous tense. So let us see one by one to them. Number one, rules for helping verb. So here had been is used as a helping verb in past perfect continuous tense with all subjects. So which helping verb will be used here? Had been in past perfect tense, in past perfect continuous tense, had been used as a helping verb with all subject. With all subject means with the singular and with the plural. Had been, you know, only had been will be used. Let's see the next rule. Rule for main verb. So here ing means fourth form of the verb is used in the past perfect continuous tense in all the sentences. In all sentences here means in affirmative, in negative, in a yes no question and in WH question. So which verb, which main verb is used? ing. It is known as a fourth form of the verb is used in past perfect continuous tense. Let's see the next rule. Here since and for. Rules for since and for. So since and for is used with certain time and uncertain time in past perfect continuous tense. So for certain time and for uncertain time, since and for is used in past perfect continuous tense. See the concept of since and for. Time is divided into two parts here, like a certain time and uncertain time. So for certain time we use since and for uncertain time we use for. So what are the certain times? Just like morning, evening, Saturday, 2 o'clock, Sunday, July, 1999, etc. So these all are considered as a certain time, and since is used, this one is used with all these, like since morning, since evening, since yesterday, since 2 o'clock, since Sunday, since July, since 1990, etc. But what are uncertain time? Like 2 hours, not 2 o'clock, 2 hours, many hours, 4 days, long time, 5 years, 2 months, 3 weeks, etc. So these all are considered as a uncertain time, and for is used with all these, as for 2 hours, for many hours, for 4 days, for a long time, for 5 years, for 2 months, for 3 weeks, etc. So for is used with these point of time, these times, and since is used with these time. I hope where since and for are used, it is clear to you all. And time, you know, the time classified here as a certain and uncertain. For certain, since is used, and for uncertain, for is used. I hope this has been cleared to you all. If it is clear, let us move to the next point, that is structure. So now here we will see the structure, first structure for affirmative. So for affirmative, we apply this one. This is structure. First of all, we write subject, then helping verb had been, then main verb, ing form, then other verb, including object, after writing other word, since or for one of them, and finally in the end time. Time will decide since will be used or for will be used or since will be used. If time will be certain, then there will be since. If time will be uncertain, then there will be for. So I hope this is structure. The structure for affirmative has been clear to you all. If it is clear, let us see some examples. Number one, see the first example. I had been waiting for her since morning. So see the first example here. I as a subject, had been as a helping verb, here waiting as a main verb, and for her here, this is for her as a other word, since here because time is certain, because morning is considered as a certain time. I hope this sentence has been clear, how it has been formed. Let us see the second example. Rani had been writing a letter for 4 hours. So here Rani as a subject, had been as a helping verb, writing as a ing form, a letter is another word, and for 4 hours. For 4 hours, because 4 hour is considered as an uncertain time. Let's see the next example. Sunil had been playing since 2 o'clock, etc. So here Sunil is a subject, had been as a helping verb, playing as a main verb, since 2 o'clock, because 2 o'clock considered as a certain time, that is why since has been used here. So I hope how is he formed, how to form and how to write affirmative sentence in past perfect continuous tense, that has been clear to you all. If it is clear, let us move to the next structure, that is structures for negative sentences. So negative sentences, we apply this structure. See very carefully to this structure. First of all, we see subject, then had, then not, then been. See, subject, had, not, then been, then ing form, then other word, since and for, and finally time. So here not in negative sentence, not comes in the middle of had and been. Not after been, it will come just before been. So let us see once again the structure of negative. Here first of all we use subject, then had, then not, then been, then ing, then other word, then since and for, and finally time. So this is the structure of negative sentence. Let us see some examples of negative sentences in past perfect continuous tense. Number one, see Radha had not been washing clothes since morning. So Radha as a subject, had been washing clothes since morning. So here see not has come just in the middle of had and been. Not, it will be written after been. So washing clothes and the rest of the point will be as same as in affirmative sentence. See the next example. That boy had not been playing since 1 o'clock. So here not has come in the middle of had and been. See the next example. They had not been learning English for 3 months. So here also been has come in the middle of had and been. Here not has come in the middle of had and been. I hope the structure, sorry, the sentences, how the sentences for negative in past perfect continuous tense has been clear to you all. If it has been clear, then let us move to the next structure, that is a structure for yes no question. So what is yes no question? A sentence which is started with a helping verb and can be answered by yes or no, that is called yes no question. Yes no question. So we will see how to write yes no question, you know, this sentence in English properly, how to arrange this sentence properly in English sentence. See, first of all we write had, then we write subject, then we write not. If not, you know, the negative sense is in in yes no question, only then we write not after a subject, and then after we use been, then ing, then other word, then since and for, then time, and finally we use question mark. So this is the structure for yes no question. Once again, let's see. First of all, we use had, then not subject, then not, if not is there, then been, ing, other words, since and for, time, and finally this one, question mark. So let us see some examples for the yes no question. See the first example. Had the child been crying for 1 hour? So here the sentence has been started with helping verb had, and then subject, then been, because not is not used, no, there is no sense of negative, that is why not has not been used here. So had the child been crying for 1 hour? See the second example. Had Mukesh been singing song in films since 1990. See this sentence has been also started with helping verb, and there is no not, that is why been has come after subject. See the next example. They had not been living in Mumbai since 2000, etc. So here subject, helping verb, then not. So here not has come after subject because there is a negative sense also. So after not, there is a been, then living, fourth form, and other word, Mumbai, in Mumbai, and since 2000, this is time, and 2000 is considered as a certain time, that is why since has been used here. I hope it has been clear. If it has been clear, let us move to the next structure, that is a structure for WH question. Structure for WH question. Let's see the structure for WH question here. So which structure we used? We use here, first of all, we write question word, means the word which is used for asking question, and then after we use had, then subject, then not, if not comes in the sentence, then been, then ing form of the verb, then other word, since and form according to time, and finally in the end time is used, and then after question marks. So question mark is used in the end of the sentence. So this is the structure for WH question. Let's see some example here for WH question. Number one, why had you been playing the match since morning? So why, this is a question word, just question, no, just after question word there is a helping verb, and the rest of the parts are used as yes no question. See the second example. Which novel had this boy been reading for 1 hour. So which novel? This is a question word. Then after, we here has been used, had has been used. See the next example. Why had you not been teaching me for 3 months, etc. So here question word, why had as a subject, sorry, helping verb, you as a subject, and not, this is a negative, because this not, this is there is a negative sense, and just after not there is a been, then teaching me for 3 months. This is as the same in yes no question, and finally in the end or there is a question marks. So these all are the examples based on the structure of WH question. I hope it has been clear. If these all have been clear, so let us see the use of past perfect continuous tense in various situations. So here we will see some rules, some points where we use past perfect continuous tense in different situation. Let's see number one. So here past perfect continuous tense is used to describe an action that began before a certain moment in the past. So where past perfect continuous tense is used, it is used to describe an action that began before where a certain moment in the past, which began where just before a certain moment in the past and continued, that action continued up to that moment or stop just before that moment, or that is continue or stopped that moment or just before that moment. So there we use past perfect continuous tense. Let us see once again where past perfect continuous tense is used. It is used to describe an action that began before, that begin before a certain moment where in the past, and that, you know, action continued to that moment or stopped just before that moment. So there we use past perfect continuous tense. Let us see some examples here. See the first example, when I met him. So when I met him, so what was there? He had already been studying English for the last 6 months. So this work was continued or maybe stopped at particular moment when it began. So when Suman arrived, see the next example. We had been waiting for her since last. So this work was continued a particular point of a time at moment, maybe when this work began, maybe this was stopped at that moment, or maybe it was continue at that moment. So see the next example, until she married him, he had been working as an accountant. So it was continue, but you know, just when this thing began, maybe this was stopped or continued at that particular moment or before that moment. So when such a things happen, when any action, you know, continue be just before beginning any action, so maybe it was stopped at particular time, or maybe it was continued at that moment, or maybe it was stopped before the moment. So there we use past perfect continuous tense. Let us see the next situation where we use where past perfect continuous tense is also used. So here see, past perfect continuous tense is also used to describe a repeated action in the past. Suppose someone had the habit of doing something time, you know, again and again. So that repeated action can be written in past perfect continuous tense. Which action? The repeated action of past perfect, that can be written in past perfect continuous tense. Let us see the examples. See the first example here. In first example, she had tried 5 times to contact him. So how many times? 5 times. This is in past perfect because had and V3 had been used. So this is past perfect continuous. So someone tried to, someone had tried 5 times, more than one time to contact for doing something. So it can be written like this. She had been trying to contact him. So this can be, easily written in past perfect continuous tense. See the next example. I had tried many times to get the job there. So this is also past perfect tense. Because here someone had repeated an action many times in past perfect. So this can be written like this. I had been trying to get the job there. Easily that can be written in past perfect continuous tense. See the next example. Ram had tried many times to learn classical dance. This is in past perfect past perfect tense. It can be because here many time he just tried to do something. So it can be written Ram had been trying to learn classical dance in past perfect continuous tense. This can be written easily. I hope this one has been clear to you all. Where and in which situation we have to use past perfect continuous tense. All right.